السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على السلام حي على السلام حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
اللهم صل على إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ به من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهديه الله تعالى فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له أرسل الرسل مبشرين ومنذرين لئلا يكون للناس على الله حجة بعد الرسل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ رسالة ربه وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا من كان من الهالكين أما بعد أيها الإخوة والأخوات في الله تعالى فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله عز وجل وخير الهدي هدي النبي محمد صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين ثم أما بعد Praise be to Allah the merciful and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم We ask Allah the Almighty, the Lord of the two worlds, as He gathered us here today, the last Jumu'ah of Ramadan, as He made us attended most of Ramadan, to accept our good deeds and to give us the strength to continue doing them till the end of Ramadan. We ask Him Almighty to make us of those who attend Laylatul Qadr and gain the reward of Laylatul Qadr. We ask Him Almighty to forgive us, forgive our parents and everyone attending today in this Jumu'ah. Ameen. Dear brothers and sisters, before I start, I would like to just make you pay attention to specifically today, Friday. And it was an odd night, witr. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, expect Laylatul Qadr in what? In the odd or the even, in the odd night. And Imam Ibn Rajab in his book, Lata'if al-Ma'arif, it's a great, very great book. But you need some mentor to go through with you, studying it. Very beautiful book. And he said that if Friday lays on an odd night, it will be most likely Laylatul Qadr. Of course, that's his ijtihad. But why not? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rahim, Rahman, and Allah is a giver. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make that night past, and today is Laylatul Qadr, and I advise you not to miss any minute today. It's only a few hours before sunset, and that day is gone. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us and make us of those who utilize the time of Laylatul Qadr. Ameen. Dear brothers and sisters, I would like to share with you that Ramadan is not for lazy people. Ramadan is for active people, for people that really get out of their box and do extra, take the next level, next step, and keep doing it without any stop. And we can see that in the history of the Sahaba, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ramadan is the end result of it. Allah will take your hand and put you in Al-Jannah. What's better than that? So don't lose it. Don't lose Ramadan. And Ramadan, you count Ramadan not by days, not by hours. That's too long. When you count, when you utilize Ramadan, you think of it a second, every second. You want to get the sense of this? Read Suratul Qadr. Allah said, Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alfi shahr. 1,000 months. Divide that 1,000 months by 12 hours, Shaykh. You will get the sense of what I'm talking about. Yes. Not by days. Not by the whole month. No. By second. By minute. And if you miss a minute, then you missed a lot. You did miss a lot. Ramadan is the month of results. Ramadan is the month of amal, injaz. Practical month. And fulfillment month, achievement month. That's the month of Ramadan. Accomplishment. And you have to look at the month of Ramadan like that. SubhanAllah, if you look at the Sahaba, when Ramadan was, before that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقُولِ اعْمَلُوا. Allah is commanding us to spend effort, to work, to practice. فَسَيَرَى اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ وَرَسُولُهُ وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah will witness what you are doing. Allah will witness whether you obey Him or you disobey Him, whether you are sincere or not sincere. So you have to be careful with that. Our ummah is عَمَلْ أُمَّةِ. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Prophet Dawood, اِعْمَلُوا آلَ Dawood, شُكْرًا. Like a shukr, Allah consider it amal. And qaleel, very few of people whom the one gives shukr, even shukr, say, Alhamdulillah, I appreciate. Thank you, Allah, thank you, my Lord. Not many of us do that. So if you look at ده صحابة رضي الله عنهم. We said that the month of Ramadan is a month of accomplish, fulfillment, achievement. While you are fasting, yeah, while you are fasting, the Sahaba went through Ghazwat Badr. That Ghazwat, that battle of Badr is a borderline between kufr and iman. That what, alhamdulillah, give us that chance to be here today. It's Ghazwat Badr. They went through Ghazwat Badr while they were fasting. Many of us nowadays, I mean, they spend Ramadan sleeping, just killing time. And they say exactly that. We kill time until iftar. No. Fath Mecca, conquering Mecca, it was in Ramadan. They were fasting also, and they did it. Allah gave them victory. So Ramadan is not for someone lazy or someone lays back. Also, Ramadan is a month of knowledge. And I don't mean by knowledge that you sit before the sheikh and you read and you learn from. No, even the scholar, if you look at the scholar like Imam al-Nawawi, many of them either wrote their book or finished their book or still going in writing their book in Ramadan. If you take Riyad al-Salihin for Imam, everyone knows Riyad al-Salihin. Look at the end. When Imam al-Nawawi wrote that book or finished that book in Ramadan. That's a big book, Sheikh. What's that tells you? He goes out of the ordinary. He wants to gain the result of knowledge. Mishkatul Masabih. Everyone knows Mishkatul Masabih. For Imam at-Tabrizi. He finished that book last day of Ramadan, Laylatul Eid. He wants to finish it in Ramadan. Ramadan is a month of barakah. Whichever you do in will benefit you. How many years that Imam Tabrizi wrote that book and we're still reading it and learning from it. He finished it in Ramadan. Also another book called Ad-Durr al-Manthur. Durr al-Manthur is a tafsir for Imam al-Suyuti. He finished it on the day of Eid. It's a big book. He finished it on the day of Eid. So that tells you that the month of Ramadan is not the month of eating, although eating is permissible, you can. It's not a month of laziness, no. For activity, any goodness you try to do, you can do it in Ramadan. And even as-salaf as-salih, they used to postpone some of their good deeds. Say, I will do it in Ramadan. To seek al-barakah and to seek the blessing out of that beautiful, beautiful month. The month of Ramadan, if you would, please, if I can ask you, my brother, there is many spaces here. You just move forward, please. Jazakumullahu khairan. Because our brothers out there standing up, this way they can have a place to sit. May Allah accept from you. The month of Ramadan is the month of taqwa. And the month of taqwa, the month of sabr. And sabr and taqwa, they are a characteristic. The adab, khuluq. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. The end result of Ramadan, you will be muttaqi. And Al-Imam Ali said about taqwa, he said, العمل بالتنزيل والخوف من الجليل والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل. Like, test yourself. Now we are at the end of Ramadan. You've been praying, you've been reading Quran, you've been coming in the masjid, praying Taraweeh, fasting. Test your taqwa. What's Quran to you? What's the sunnah to you? You apply all of them exactly as Allah said, and as the Prophet and as the scholar advise, where you stand. In the bottom, in the middle, at the end,
That's taqwa. That will tell you. That's the gauge of your taqwa, where you are. And as I said, taqwa is khuluq. And you here today, mashallah, you here today. Not to listen to me. No. You here today preparing for your akhirah, for yawm al-qiyamah, to ask Allah to accept and to let you enter al-jannah. The month of Ramadan teaches you as-sabr. And subhanallah, as-siyam, nisf as-sabr. Sawm is half of the sabr. So if you fast sincerely, you will have half of as-sabr, patience. Then the other half, you struggle with it. You're going to struggle with only one half. One half. And that's also, as-sabr is khuluq. Is adab, and the end result of Ramadan giving you enough. So a man came to the Prophet ﷺ and he said, "O Prophet of Allah, advise me." The Prophet said, "La taghdab." Only one word. And the man even he said, "La taghdab, what's la taghdab? Only one word. I'm asking for a big advice." The man needs a lecture. But then he said, "Maybe the Prophet ﷺ bade you." He asked him again. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, "La taghdab." That means something. That khuluq means something. La taghdab. Al-ghadab always shaitan. Now, someone comes to you, Shaykh, and charge at you and wants to hit you, wants to get a piece of you, something like what we always say. And then you just say, "Inni sa'im." Because a sa'im does not do no good. You can. You're powerful. You have muscles. You can bring that man down in no time. Yes. But you are controlled by fasting. I'm fasting. And when you say to him, "I'm fasting," that means I'm controlling my power. That's why I'm not touching you. And I'm leaving this for Allah. And then while you're saying that to him, you're advising him also. And then that man came with all this anger, and then you tell him you're fasting, he will remember and say, "Subhanallah, it's a month of Ramadan, I'm fasting too. I should not do that." That's also an advice. That's coming out from fasting, from a sabr, from controlling your desire of enmity. Dear brothers and sisters, the month of Ramadan is the month of tarbiyah. The month of tarbiyah. And when we say the month of tarbiyah, we say that uprising, upbringing. I don't like those words, I don't know why, but it teaches you something. Even that something is little, that's fine. That's fine. The month of Ramadan will raise your bar of Iman. The month of Ramadan, you between fasting and Qiyam. Qiyam al-Layl, Taraweeh. And both of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what he said? He said, "Man sama Ramadan, Imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." He's speaking about the whole month. And then he said, "Man qama Ramadan, Imanan wa ihtisaban," with sincerity, "only for you, my Lord, I'm fasting and I am praying, you will be forgiven." So you are between Siyam and Qiyam. Let's say you missed it, all of it. And alhamdulillah, nowadays we still have few days. And we don't know when is Laylatul Qadr. We assume and we ask Allah. And Allah will give, inshallah, according to your sincerity. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "You don't have to worry. One night could wipe everything like siyam and qiyam. Man qama laylatul qadr, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." That's why you have to be careful. You have to be careful, and you have to try to gain laylatul qadr. Dear brothers and sisters, in Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking you to control the dunya desire. The dunya desire, like what? You pass by McDonald's and you go and buy a sandwich, even though you're not hungry. And there is people, they're very hungry, they don't have that sandwich. They don't have clean water to drink. They don't have a piece of bread to eat. And you eat half of the sandwich and you throw the other half in the garbage. You don't eat it. That's what we do. That's what our children do. What they do is half of our food put on the table end up in the garbage can. So Ramadan teach you something. You've never been hungry before. Especially us here, alhamdulillah, Allah blessed us with life here. We don't feel about hunger. But when you fast, you say, subhanallah, I feel like I want to eat. And I could not eat. What about those poor people waiting for you, for your zakah, for your sadaqah, to give them to have a decent meal? Wallahi, believe it or not, some people, they waiting for us to provide them with decent meal across the globe. Of course, you don't know them. And they raise their hand and make dua for you. So I just want you to pay attention and utilize the rest of Ramadan. Yes, Ramadan is gone, but we still have time. You still have chance. And if you start Ramadan no good, try to end Ramadan good. You know what's going to happen if you end Ramadan good and you start Ramadan no good? Allah will forgive you the past for you. See how merciful Allah is? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the right rituals and right ibadat and right akhlaq. From practicing Ramadan. Ameen. أقول قولي هذا وصل. الحمد لله وحده وأصلي وأسلم على من لا نبي بعده. Praise be to Allah the Merciful and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Usually when you mention Ramadan, you remember generosity. And generosity is a big word, is a big field. Generosity to you, I'm coming here to collect money from you. That's generosity to you. You only think about money. But this is wrong thinking. It is. It is part of it. But also generosity, sparing good akhlaq, good smile to you. The Prophet, the Sahabi, one of the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, one time, he said, I never met the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam without him giving me a smile. Look at all of you now. We are in Ramadan. Last Friday in Ramadan. And everyone, subhanAllah, looking at me like I killed his father or something. Sparing even that smile is not there. That's generosity. You spare good khuluq, good adab. That's karam. That's karam. Is not only, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to go beyond any level you know. A man came to him sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, O Prophet of Allah, give me. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, I don't have. Khalas, you don't have. Umar said, you don't have. Khalas. Radiallahu anhu. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he asked that man, he said, go to the grocery store or go to the market and buy whichever you like. And tell them, Muhammad will pay. What kind of level is this? Can you do that level? You remember in our country, we go back to the grocery store, and until we get the check, the end of the month, we say to the grocery store manager, we say, okay, I'm buying this and that, write them on my account. And he write them on your account. At the end of the month, you pay. The Prophet ﷺ did that. He said, go buy, but don't write your name, write my name. I will pay for it. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, he said, O Prophet of Allah, you don't have to do that. Khalas, you don't have. And then Bilal, as I remember, he said, no, Prophet of Allah, amfiq. ولا تخف من ذي العرش إقلالا. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم kind of liked what Bilal said. He liked that because this is karam, and that's his level صلى الله عليه وسلم. We're not asking you to do that, but we're asking you at least to be a giver in this month of Ramadan. And also to complete, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم get a little upset about Umar saying this, and he became happy with the other saying, give. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to give till nothing in his house, even for his family. Aisha رضي الله عنها أمنا, she used to give until her slave, her Amma, she used to tell her, oh Aisha, you didn't leave nothing for us to eat. You know what Aisha said رضي الله عنها, she said, if you reminded me, I would have remembered. She don't remember him, herself. She learned that from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So I'm here on behalf of Islamic Relief, and we're trying to collect some fund for our brothers and sisters, the victims of the earthquakes in Turkey and Syria. I know you donated a lot initially to just save them from the initial shock they have. And now we need to establish them, inshallah. $1,000 could be very helpful to the whole family for 1 year. I will be waiting outside, inshallah. We accept credit card, we accept check, we accept cash. Try to donate as much as you can. May Allah reward you and accept from all of you. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا وارحمنا وارحم موتانا وانصرنا على من عادانا إنك على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا. اللهم بارك لنا في رمضان. اللهم تقبل منا الصلاة والصيام والقيام وصالح الأعمال. اللهم اغفر لمن له حقوق علينا إنك على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. وصل اللهم وسلم وزد وبارك على النبي وآله. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أشهد أن محمد رسول الله, أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. هيا للصلاة هيا للصلاة هيا للفلاح هيا للفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
I just, dear brother, I couldn't make sujood because I have operation in my knee. So one of my students will lead the prayer, inshallah. Jazakumullah khairan. May Allah accept, ya Rab.
So straighten your lines, fill in the gaps. Make room for our brothers in the back. الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات يهديهم ربهم بإيمانهم تجري من
تحتهم الأنهار في جنات النعيم دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم وتحيتهم فيها سلام وآخر دعواهم أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين فذلك الذي يدع اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون الذين هم يراءون ويمنعون الماعون. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. Just a couple of quick announcements. In addition to our brothers in the back at Islamic Relief fundraising, we also have the robotics team going to World Championships. They are outside. They are a rookie team, and they are a team with Hafiz and Hafiza that are fasting and competing during the competition. They'll be reading Quran in competition, praying Salah during competition, and they do need your donations. So you can go ahead and donate to them outside in Islamic Relief at the back of the lobby. Tomorrow night is our construction fundraiser in addition to our weekly community iftar. So you can come out and enjoy both of those things. Our Eid toy drive with the kids committee is going to be tomorrow at 2 o'clock. So you can bring a wrapped or unwrapped gift with wrapping supplies and join us in the ICF lobby for that. We're also celebrating first-time fasters for many children who have fasted for the first time. That's on April 17th at 9 p.m. You can RSVP at tinyurl.com/first-time-fasters. And also a reminder that our Eat Salah is going to be at Rough Riders Field on Friday, April 21st at 9:30 a.m. We are doing it in conjunction with the Aubrey Masjid, McKinney Masjid, ICQC. Again, that's going to be at Rough Riders Field. You can see the flyer posted on the board or at the office. So inshallah, we will see everybody on April 21st at 9:30. Jazakumullah, everybody.